Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, an iOS 13.3 that I have running on my iPhone XS Max, an iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1 that I have running on my iPhone 11 Pro Max have been out for weeks now. Thanks to the holiday season, we haven't seen a different update or a new update. And now that we're past New Year's, it's probably going to be time for an update. So I would expect an update probably within this coming week. If we took a look back at the previous year, it was released, I believe, on the 6th or the 5th. So we should see an update right around Monday, I would expect. So by the time you're watching this, it could be already or could already be out, or it may be out in the next day or so. And so depending on which version you're on, I would expect a beta update that day. I would not expect iOS 13.3 to be updated to a new version very quickly. Apple is sort of slowing everything down, I think, to get things right. And with 13.3, there have certainly been some issues. While many people don't have issues, quite a few do have issues. And so I looked back at the YouTube community poll like I did last week when I did one of these videos, and still people are commenting about it. So we'll take a look at that in a moment. But for those of you using 13.3, some people are saying that battery is good. I would say that's about 30 to 40% of you, but I would say the majority on 13.3 are saying battery isn't so great. Now, anything beyond that is hard to say because it's been out for weeks and people are still having issues. Everything from connections to LTE, to battery, to apps crashing, things like that. While I do find it to be more stable than previous versions, for the most part, I do see quite a few issues, and people still comment to me or comment or contact me every single day about it. Now, I've personally been running iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1, and it's been really hit or miss. I really don't have a whole lot of complaints about battery. So if I go into settings, we'll go to battery here and take a look at what it's like today. My battery health is still at 100%, still charging this every single night. And this is my main device. I haven't moved my SIM card or anything like that. And today, it's been 2 hours and 11 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 35 minutes of screen off time, and I've barely used any of it. In fact, you can see I have 95% of my battery life left, and that's doing really well. Now, to be fair, it did charge in my car wirelessly for a little bit today, but if we take a look back, one of the best days I had here where I used almost 100% of my battery, but a lot of that was Maps. So Maps takes a tremendous amount of power when you're using it. I had 7 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 18 minutes of screen off time. I went for a trip somewhere, came back, and Maps, 39% of my battery went to Maps. So it used a tremendous amount of power, and that's 7.5 hours on battery alone for GPS is incredible. Didn't plug it in at all. The next day I did, but let's take a look at what we had the other day. Normally I say about 10 to 12 hours of screen on time, depending how you're using it. So you'll see this day I used just over 25% of my battery and got 2.5 hours of screen on time and almost 2.5 hours or 2 hours and 22 minutes of screen off time. So going times four with that, we're getting about 10 hours in that case, and then a lot of screen off time as well. So it's actually doing incredibly well for me. I have no complaints with this update, and I can't wait for you to try it out once the betas are done from those moving from 13.3 over to 13.3.1. I think it'll fix battery for most people. Now, there are going to be exceptions to that where people don't have good battery, but overall it seems to be okay. The one area I continually have issues and then don't have issues, I mentioned in the last follow-up that I had no issues going from Wi-Fi to LTE. Now I'm having those issues again over the past couple days. So when I switch from Wi-Fi to LTE, sometimes I go into Safari, for example. This wallpaper will be in a different video, and there it worked just fine. So maybe we'll go to my website here, and it's loading just fine. So that switch over had no problem. It might be a little bit slow, but that could be my website. In fact, it probably is my website, but let's try Apple. And you'll see Apple loaded nice and fast. So if we go to Apple, go to buy AirPods that you can now engrave with emojis if you want, everything's working fine. So that switch over worked fine, but sometimes it doesn't work well. And I've seen this from people on 13.3, 13.3.1, and I'll show you that in a comment in just a moment. Other than that, I've really had no issues with this on the beta. Beta 1 for me has been great, for others not so much, but for me, really no issues. Apple Pay, everything like that is working fine. So I really am looking forward to beta 2. It's been a long time since we had an update. And so this week we should see some sort of update, I would imagine. Now, other than that, iOS 14, we'll see the first of that in June. So I'm really excited about that. And so I thought about making a video about predictions of what could be in 2020. So let me know if that's something you'd want to see. Now, based on the YouTube community poll, let me show you this really quickly. Now, the YouTube community poll for 13.3, there was a new comment. Actually, today, when I went and looked, it had been posted 34 minutes ago. So you'll see people continue to vote on 13.3, 23,000 votes. So I really appreciate that. And still people are saying data and Wi-Fi issues, battery life is terrible. The battery really stinks, bad battery on iPhone 7. So like I said, on that version, not so great. But I still would have updated on that one for most people due to security reasons. If this will open here, I'll show you. There we go. And you'll see there's still 20,000 votes here. Not really any new comments, but if we look at the top ones, people are having cellular connection issues. So that seems to be the biggest issue. Some people are having battery life issues, but really I'm not having any after the few days. So just depends what you're doing and I suppose what phone you're on. Now, here's a couple comments I wanted to show you that people left. They just left two. One of them said, I have to agree with the others. The software on my 8 has had detrimental impacts on battery, usually not even lasting a work day. This is from a couple of weeks ago, and this has to do with iOS 13.3, just like I have on the iPhone XS Max here. And then another comment that was posted a little bit over an hour ago at this point, it says, I've had my iPhone 8 on 13.3 for 3 weeks now. The biggest bug I'm encountering is the LTE connectivity bug or issue. Hard resets don't fix it, or doesn't fix it. iMessages don't deliver half the time due to this. Very, very annoying. So some people are having that issue still. I know some people say it's not an issue, and I'm glad if it's not an issue, but if you have one of the newer devices that has an Intel modem in it, so basically an iPhone 10, depending on the variant you have and newer, you could have those issues. And that's really it for this particular follow-up. I just wanted to keep a consistent weekly follow-up for you. So let me know what you think in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.